What a glorious sight. See that little butterfly there around the shrubbery here in Montfabri, just outside the central business districts of Bangkok here, northern Bangkok. And it's a glorious impact arena with these stunning shrubs and manicured lawns. Really nice. And it's as well kept inside as it is outside. Dressed beautifully, wonderfully staged here for this HSBC BWF World Tour Finals. We've got two results for you. Lee and Shin down in Chow and Lee of Malaysia. And setting up an all-Korean women's doubles final. Kim and Kong taking down Kitty Harikun and Prajongjai of Thailand. So it is indeed Lee and Shin against Kim and Kong tomorrow for the women's doubles title decider. Now then, from women's doubles on to men's doubles keenly. Repeat of Group B's match on Thursday. The daddies, Ahsan and Setiawan, come into this one 0-3 head-to-head. Surely they can notch a win against the very tough Koreans that won Group B. The daddies came second in Group B. That's how they qualified. But with a final spot up for grabs, you'd imagine that Ahsan and Setiawan will be roused for this. That's how the land lies. Lee Yang and Wang Qilin at the very top of the draw, taking on Ben Lane and Sean Bendy of England. And we are second semi-final later today, our fifth match that'll be. And a sandwich in between, we've got a women's singles win, and Siyong and Tai Tzu Ying. But for now, turning our attention onto this one, the first of our men's doubles semi-finals from the bottom of the draw. Look at the profile of these two on the left. Look how many wins they've amassed. Quite outstanding. They've been a long-standing partnership, and that there really representative of what they've been up to. Very few losses relative to that tally of 265 career wins.
Men's double semi-final. Please welcome Muhammad Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan from Indonesia.
Muhammad Ahsan, of course, recent daddy of a young girl. Twins as well to go along with the newborn. What a rich and fruitful career these two have had over the years. Former number ones of August 2014, long time ago now. They've always been there or thereabouts. Three times and reigning world champions in men's doubles.
And please welcome Choi So-kyu and Seo Soon-jae from Korea.
And these two, very much the nemesis opponents of the Indonesians, who already are on court, lying in wait. Choi So-kyu and Seo Soon-jae. Seo, of course, very busy. He's got mixed doubles today. That's the very last match on, match 10 after this. He'll get a good rest, of course. And there is Choi So-kyu. He's a compatriot. They twin together so nicely, these two. They really do. Immaculate in defense. And, well, three wins out of three matches against Ahsan and Setiawan. Is today the day that things turn around? Let's find out.
Umpire Emmanuel Kabuizile from Botswana. Service judge Pramila Asawaposo from Thailand.
Winners of Group B take on the second place players, or team I should say, from Group B. Winners in blue.
Okay, starts red this side and black this side. Red. Okay. Okay, you're on the toss. You take the court, you save or receive. Receive, who is receiving? Who's receiving? Who's saving?
Begin. All the preparations have been made. And strapping on his calf over the last couple of weeks, but he seems to be okay. He's not impeded or hampered in any way by that. The 33-year-old Mohammed Ahsan recent daddy to newborn little girl. Congratulations, Mohammed. Lovely moments, aren't they? That supersedes all of this, those new additions to the fam. And Hendra Setiawan, 36-year-old partner, just 3 years older. Pamelang. How will they go today? That's their route through. And as you can see, they had two wins, Ahsan and Setiawan. Down the Russians, 21-17 in the third. Lost to Choi Seo, but they played today. But also a win over the crafty Malaysians, Jian Sok Uyik, 21-11 in three quarters of an hour needed there. So it was a really tight, well-contested game, and nobody with a clean sheet. These guys could only amass two wins and one loss, despite winning the group. Choi Sulyuk and his partner Seo Sungjae, 25 years old now. That's Choi from Seoul. Very busy man today. As I said, he's got mixed doubles up later, 2 years younger. The sole left-hander on the court. He's a beautiful player to watch, so smooth on the shuttle, a really good server as well. And that's something that his partner can sometimes get a little nerve-riddled, and the serve kind of perhaps the weakest facet of Choi's game, really. Though he brings other qualities, and this is their route through. Took out the Russians, as well as the Indonesians, but lost, strangely, to Chia and Seoul. So that's how the lad lied in led, I should say, in Group B. But can, a big question on everybody's lips, can the Malaysians, who say hello to this Botswana umpire?
Indonesians.
The Indonesians find a way through a 0-3 head-to-head against today's opponents, Morton? It's a tough ask, isn't it?
It is. It's like Choi and Seo, they really don't care about whether they have to defend or not. So what they do, they play with very good height to their lift, which means that the two Indonesian players are not really being able to feed off the pace of flatter lift and so on, which makes it quite difficult for Ahsan and Setiawan to attack from the back of the court. And when they're up against such a good defense as the Koreans are having, then it's trouble. But I think you pinpointed it as well, because it's also up to Choi to see how many points is he going to gift away in this match on the surf. That's a critical point.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Seung Sin Jai and Choi Sulgyoi, Korea. And on my left, Hendra Setiawan and Mohammed Ahsan, Indonesia. Mohammed Ahsan to serve to Seung Sin Jai, Lahore, play. One love. One all.
Lucky break off the net there, favouring the Koreans.
Yeah, Ahsan almost got it back.
Yeah.
Just sticking his racket out and then hoping for the best.
Oh. 2-1.
I think he prefers to serve with a used shuttle. He doesn't like to serve with a new shuttle. Ah, that's a good return from Setiawan.
Service over. 2-2.
Salty old sea dog, isn't he? 36 years of age and he's been around the block. He's terrific to watch. So experienced.
Yeah, he himself is not the best server either, but he's a better server than Choi.
Out.
Just mentioned it.
Yeah, you jinxed it, didn't you? He's nervous.
Three, all.
Who wouldn't be nervous staring down to a team you've never beaten before in three previous attempts? He's going to have to be keen with the footwork and agility today, isn't he, Mohammed Ahsan, and securing a lot of points like that. He's moving well.
He's moving a lot better than what we saw earlier. Seems to have recovered from his calf injury.
Service over for all.
This match is already into the usual pattern. Very, very short rallies all around the service situation, flat exchanges.
Service over 5-4. Service over 5-5.
Stunning from Setiawan.
Service over.
The threat in itself.
Five.
He can do whatever he wants, but the block shot, of course, very, very efficient.
Service one called too high. Service over.
And this is
six,
also what we see.
Four.
Is happening to Choi, so fault it for being too high. Well played by Ahsan.
When they're playing at their best, these two, rather like Lin Dan in a way, they just seem to have the ability, they see the shuttle so early that they're majestic, they almost just saunter around the court. Persistence in the Indonesian attack. Choi wilting in the end.
Well, here we got a taste of what the Koreans can do. They can really keep good pressure on Ahsan and Setiawan and keep them working back up the court because of their so solid defense. And once again, look at that block shot. Elegant.
9-6.
And then it also has to be said that Seo Sung-jae is not the quickest of players. Oh, that's a good return.
On that note,
seven,
it was like a rocket
nine,
all over that, wasn't it?
Yeah, good reactions.
Service over 10-8.
I think we're in for a tight
nine,
affair here.
Ten.
And one of the questions are, can Ahsan and Setiawan cut down on their mistakes?
Eight.
Well, that it's such a fine line they tread, isn't it, the Indonesians, between sort of tempered aggression and consistency, but they're blending it nicely so far. 11-9, the Taddies have a 2-point lead in game one.
Ngadu nggak kalah, jangan buru-buru. Ketiga di depan jangan nyodok, terus direm, terus kena dia. Dua jaganya belakang banget. Belakang banget, codok pertama, codok balikannya taruh. Ya, lagi nggak enak, ada ajar ke tengah dulu. Nembaknya jangan yang sini, yang kanan, yang kiri, backhand. Pembukaannya
udah disana.
Oke, pegang terus, Fresh. Yakin, depannya servisnya dorong panjang ini.
Another well blended attack here. Lovely flat hard drive there from Mohammed Ahsan.
Same silver. Turn 12.
A little handshaking gesture that they want the shuttle changed. Once again, awesome serve from Sosun Jay. He's a really good server. And hopefully I haven't jinxed him now. That wouldn't be fair. Another good, fantastic serve. Good play by Ahsan. Trying that across the body of Choi. Directly towards the right hip. And it's so efficient. Try to look at this, it's coming now. That's the one. Really snappy drive, wasn't it? What a miss it.
What he sees himself there, doesn't he? With a dry smile of delight after that one. He enjoyed that.
As did coach Harry.
Yeah, he had a smile on his face as well, even though we couldn't see it. We could see it in his eyes. There, an example of Susan Jay not the quickest, but of course you can also see he's standing very far back on the court.
Well, time seemed to stand still for a moment there with Setiawan, didn't it? He sort of was just
15,
poised
11.
And then decided to play the shuffle on the back line. Stop on the points at 3
15.
For these two. I think Choi is benefiting from the fact that his serve has not been faulted yet, which means that he's still got a little bit of confidence in what he's doing.
Good leave.
Yeah,
that was good.
15, 16.
So it's on Jay. He doesn't mind whether it's a used shuttle or a new one. He very often changes the shuttles when he's serving, where it's completely opposite to the partner, Choi Soo-ryul.
Four. 15-16. Same silver, 17-14.
It's a good opportunity.
15-17. I still think,
I'm not sure that Ahsan is still 100%. And it's not because the way he moves on court, but it's merely the fact that we see Hendra Setiawan working a lot more from the back than what he will do under normal circumstances. Just a small indication of the fact that maybe he's sort of saving part time, working a lot more from the back than what, as I say, he would normally do.
Call! 16-17.
And that, of course, is hammering the performance from the Indonesians, because what is happening is that Ahsan is having a much better attack from the back than Setiawan is having. So, because he's able to not alone hit harder, but he's also able to play more steep smashes.
Semi-silver, 18-16. Service over, 17-18.
So just 1 point in it.
Yeah, only 4 points has been the maximum that they've been separated, these two, in favour of Ahsan and Setiawan earlier in the game. But now it's getting tight again, and we saw this, didn't we, a couple of days ago, and suddenly the Koreans then just accelerated towards the opening game. Again there.
18-all.
It's interesting because Ahsan and Setiawan is having this reputation. As soon as they get to 19, they will win. But I agree with you, it did not happen last week against this pair.
Six out of the last eight for the Koreans.
Taking that face off, but this is awesome by Ahsan.
Oh, he took over there, didn't he?
He did.
Really well played, man.
19-18.
Massive point. Took ownership of it nicely.
From Mohamed Ahsan,
20 game points,
setting up to game points, 20 game points, 18.
He's been standout last couple of points, this man, like a dynamo everywhere at once.
This was called too high.
I think that's second time.
Six over.
Ahsan has been faulted on his free serve. See, once again, Ahsan is asking for the shuttle to be changed. Once again, Choi is denying it. So this serve from Choi.
He was great there, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Looking for the third shot so keenly.
See, once again,
change the shot.
He didn't want to change it. However, the umpire told him to change it, which is quite interesting. So now the big test is coming.
Blake.
Still the service fairly okay. It was not a really bad one, but look at the ease on that return from Ahsan. Good pressure, setting up yet another game point.
Yeah, number three.
Yes, and that's out. It's gone. Yeah.
Yes.
That's out.
Singapore.
So proactive there, weren't they?
He found the gap.
Yeah, lovely backhand drive, but just wide.
Oh, what can you do?
High quality from Hendra Setiawan.
What can you do? 22-21.
Look at that return. Try to have a look at this one.
A moment of magic. Found the tumbler. Fourth game point. And today might be the day as Ahsan and Setiawan take the opening game, 23-21 after 18 minutes against very tough opponents.
Jadi Ahsan Hendra ngangkatnya jangan lupa kalau yang ke kidal itu ke overhead aja supaya dia itu dia paling lurus-lurus lah, lurus tinggal kita ngaturnya itu satu, kedua drive-nya berani adu, tenaga mereka juga sudah mulai turun ya, kuncinya tetap main di depan, main megang aja depan, satu, dua mereka jarang naruh, setengah semua, nah setengahnya ini tinggal naruh, kalau mau sabet itu jangan lurus satu sisi. Twenty seconds.
So here we go then. Can they sustain this very high quality that they've brought to the court? It was such a tight opening game. 23-21 in their favour. Here we go, start of game number two.
Second game, love ball, play. One love.
Oh, what an interception there from Ahsan.
Two love.
So some Jay doing everything he can to get it across, all in vain.
Save silver. One, two. Three, one.
not surprisingly, it's Mohamed Ahsan that's putting that one away. Kept the attack nicely, Setiawan on three occasions, but the final shot down the line is coming from Ahsan. More pace and power. Perfect serve from a man that's not so safe when it comes to serving. Another one there.
6-1.
Two fantastic services. Well spotted by Choi.
Service over. 2-6.
So it's becoming increasingly important for Seosun Jae. Partner Choi will get some points now, because otherwise the train is running away from them. Yeah, well placed by Ahsan.
Yeah, and it does so easily become a train, doesn't it? These guys so richly experienced, they know when to squeeze, and it'll be around now just to create a chasm between them. That's what it's all about. It's missed as well. The Indonesians are motoring. It's a string break for Seosun Jae.
Variation, three power smashes and a block shot. And once again, Seosun Jae is a little bit exposed on these block shots. Not comfortable when he's got to move forward in such a situation.
Service over 3-9. Super return of serve from Ahsan.
Service over.
Yeah, the serve was
3.
Not bad, but it was not good either. And that's not good enough when you're playing against the players like the Ahsan and Setiawan.
6-4.
He's so good playing this disruptive style play. Always ensuring that their opponents never get into a rhythm.
Super block, we'll set it up.
6-4.
Into the mid-game interval with a lead of 11-4 after having won the opening game 23-21. It's looking good for Mohamed Ahsan and Hindu Setiawan.
Tiga nembaknya jangan kenceng terus arah ke tengah, kalau dari belakang kanan itu ke tengah ya, terus sama ngerem ada bacok sininya juga boleh ngeremnya. Kombinasi dia jaganya udah belakang terus, udah panik ya. Jadi kita yang mainin arahnya, tembak kenceng terpelan, kalau kenceng terus dia siap belakang pegang terus dari servisnya panjang, pegang teman ya.
Finish, ya. Second. For play.
A little bit too much stick on that Six double clash.
5-11.
Now these to, not used to being in this situation against these opponents. They've normally had a stranglehold over them with three consecutive wins in the past. Not today, though.
Six over 12-5.
I would not be surprised if Ahsan and Setiawan are winning this tournament. I would not be surprised.
They suddenly look a lot better, like they sat down, had a real good chat, you know, about the way things have gone and kind of figured something very subtle out. Did well there to get back into that point as well, just denied the back end of it, but salvaging something. Now what about the Koreans? Do they really believe they can get a fourth win? It's a tough ask.
It is, but I don't think they've lost hope. They're good fighters. Oh, that's a beautiful interception from Su Sung Jae.
7-13.
Oh, look at that. That's the power. And that's the angle I was talking about.
14-7.
Look at this second one here.
Choi.
Completely catching Choi. That's a wonderful smash from Mohammed Ahsan. Serve of Shogo.
Yeah, familiar failings.
Yeah. And that is going to be interesting to see whether that will influence his serving for the rest of this match. First,
Nine,
some joke to
15.
Serve. Next time the Koreans are getting a serve, it will be Choi to serve.
So well, didn't he? What play from the front court from Sulio there.
Outstanding.
Lovely block, and then that one. Hanging in the air, Michael Jordan-esque.
So it's suddenly believable.
11,
yeah,
15.
It is. Two in a row.
Usually when the Koreans are getting these points in a row, it's always a Susan Jay that's serving.
Cool. Venomous. Trio of smashes from the Indonesians there just to stop the run of points. And they're going to be a tough team to stop, the Indonesians. Now they've got that lead. It's a 5-point cushion, but with all their experience, they know what they're up to.
Seventeen, eleven. 16-11.
This time it was Ahsan intercepting at the net on the third shot. Got away with that cross. I think it's a foregone conclusion. I cannot see Ahsan and Setiawan losing this one. Once again, saved by Setiawan. Touching the t-shirt.
Service over. 12-18.
Well, it's been hard for, hasn't it, for the Koreans. They've been given very little unforced errors, and having to work extremely hard like that, really symbolic of what they've had. The Indonesian defence has been pretty immaculate.
Choi is taking a lot of chances, and some are working out, others not. This was a chance as well. Trying to do the same as what he did earlier, but it's a very risky shot. Super Setiawan all over the net there.
20,
and suddenly, in the blink of an eye, after 33 minutes of action, Ahsan and Setiawan look like they might register a win against Choi and Seo.
Yeah, denied the first time around.
13-20.
Good attack on that surf.
There it is, and they will be delighted inside. A terrific day at the office for these two, Mohammed Ahsan and Hendra Setiawan, coming through in straight games in some style against opponents they've never beaten before in three previous attempts. That is quite a turnaround, and to do so in straight games, just showing mentally that they find the edge on those biggest of occasions. They are through in the bottom half of the men's doubles draw to the semi-final. Well, we'll lie in wait for the winner of Lee Wang and Ben Lane. So Ahsan and Setiawan, confirmation that they win through in the first men's doubles semi-final, 23-21, 21-13. What a win that was. Do their confidence the world of good. And the thrice reigning world men's doubles champions head on through. Well, up next, we've got this young 18-year-old Korean called Ahsan Young. She takes on the world number one, Tai Su-Ying. We'll be up after a very short break. Put the kettle on, cup of tea, and join us again. We'll be right back. Sun's still beating down out there. We've been here a month, not seen a drop of rain. It's been beautiful conditions outside. Lovely war.